Hi, thanks for joining me. So today I want to just show off a little something here that you guys might not be thinking about. I've been trying to just take it a little bit easy here, do something fun, and get in touch with some more of my cool stuff here. So I've been setting up this CRT. I've been wanting to play on this more for a long time. This is like a 20-inch CRT, which I think is really great for kind of an arcade like experience. And but one thing I was really worried about, I noticed it specifically when I hooked up this game here, which is Cannon Spike, that some of the text gets cut off, and I guess I should probably just hop into the game. It actually looks good currently. Let's go ahead and actually get into the game here. It looks good currently because I actually fixed the issue with this set. So I wanted just to let you guys know how I did that in case, you know, you guys are running into a similar issue, because you know, I almost gave up on this thinking, oh man, that this you know, this isn't actually going to work out. This TV that I have, it just, you know, it's got this overscan problem. So what was happening, where you see down the lower right hand corner, it says credits 3. And I think on the top too, where it says like press start button, you know, it was just things were getting cut off just enough that it was annoying. You know, I'm like, oh man, if I have to play all my games like this, this just isn't going to work out. So what I ended up doing was looking up online, and I found out how to get into the service menu on this television. So you know, I was a little nervous because, you know, they say, you know, you want to be a trained technician and don't get in here. It's really for like setting the settings at the factory, or, you know, somebody that's doing real service work on the TV that knows how to calibrate them to mess around with. But you know, people basically are saying as long as you write down the values that they're at, you can always put them back there. And you know, if you can get into it, mess around with the settings and see if you can get it the way you want it. So I'll show you guys how to do this. On mine it's really convoluted. But I guess most of the Panasonic TVs are the same. You guys could look up the codes for your TV if you've got one, and if you're having trouble with overscan, this could really help. So with mine, let's see, I have to select the setup icon and select cable mode. So let's give that a whirl. We're going to go over to setup and set mode. Huh, that's the mode for closed captions, and that's auto power on off. Maybe this was part that I couldn't do. Okay, because it wasn't exactly the way that this said. So select the timer icon and set sleep timer for 30 minutes. Alright, let's try that one. So sleep timer, 30 minutes. Okay. Press the action button, yada yada. So then it says go to channel 124. So I'm going to do that. Channel 124. Adjust the volume to 0. So we'll turn the volume all the way down. And hit the volume down button on the TV itself, and a red check should appear, which never happened, but I'm gonna try doing it. So here's volume down. Oh, there it did, actually. Okay, check. Alright, so, I never noticed that before, but that is working. So, so this is, I guess, the mode, and so I can press action and volume down buttons again, and I'll toggle between, it seems like aging, and serviceman modes. Select serviceman mode. The power button on the remote will select one of the 5 serviceman adjustments. Okay. I don't really know what that means, but let me just see if I hit power right now. Alright, this is, I think, what I'm looking for. So let me, I'm going to put this on the video input, and that'll give us a little easier way to see this stuff. Oh, okay, actually, no. These are just the different modes. Okay, so B, so they have here on this guide, B is this certain set of serviceman modes, and then C is like a different set, and then S is a different set, and then M is a different set. So I'm just toggling through those with the power button. So B is really what I was interested in with this set in particular. So you can see here that this is B0 and it's set to 17. That's the value of it. There's only one value to each one of these. I'm just using like channel up and down to select these. So B1 is set to 43. This is B2, B3, B4, B5, B6, and B7. That's all of them for the Bs. So there's a little description here of what those, you know, more or less should be. I don't even know what some of these things mean. I don't know why they're called sub, but they're sub tint, sub color, sub brightness, sub contrast, color killer slash ABL slash gamma, audio and video adjustment, and vertical size. So all I really cared about was vertical size. So I took a guess that it was B7, I believe. And what it used to be set at is 30. So let me go ahead and change that so you guys can see what this used to look like. That is 30. And I don't know how well you can see it. I'll go ahead and, you know, zoom in here a little bit. But you can see that it kind of cuts the text off a little bit on the top and bottom there. And I just went ahead and changed that until I thought it looked pretty good, which was at 23. And that was it, you know? And just, you know, for me, just being able to adjust this myself, and this really went from something where, you know, I think people, it's sad to me to see people, like, you know, throwing these CRTs away. I get it, they're, you know, they're old and a lot of people don't have use for them, but these are excellent, excellent for your old game systems like this. You know, people go way out of their way to, you know, hook these systems up to new HD TVs and to do scanline generation and all that stuff. When really, you know, the best way to play these is still on the original CRTs that they were meant to be played on. So, you know, if you have a nice one, it's really worth it to, you know, to try to use it to play these systems. I think it can be a really great way to do that. So, one of my friends has this same trouble on his newer HD TV. You know, it has overscan, it's a projection style. So, you know, there are other instances where this this could come in handy. So, just so you know, there is a service menu for your TV. You can get into it and change settings like this. So, I found that really useful. I hope you guys did too, and I hope you'll join me again for more video game and anime related videos.